Hello all, this is Dr. Alsip, and in this video we will be focused on the arteries that supply muscles of mastication, which are all branches of the maxillary nerve for the most part. We will delve into the branches of all the branches of the maxillary artery in the next session, but we're just going to focus on a few right now, so let's get started. Okay, let's try to understand what has been dissected and removed in this image. We are looking at a lateral view with a good portion of the ramus of the mandible being removed. You can see here is the angle of the mandible. This is the ramus, and a good portion has been removed, leaving a little bit of the mandibular condyle here to get an idea of where TMJ is going to be located. And so this really will afford a view, because the masseter muscle has been removed with the ramus, so you can really see the deeper lateral pterygoid, or portions of it here, as well as the medial pterygoid here. So this really affords a nice view of the second part of the pterygoid part of the maxillary artery. So you can see that right in this region here. So it's the second part that's really closely associated with the lateral pterygoid muscle. It's either just superficial to or just deep to, which in this case you can see it is superficial to the lateral pterygoid. These three arteries are all going to be branches of the second part. In fact, all branches of the second part of the maxillary artery supply muscles of mastication and supporting and surrounding tissues. We'll talk about some of those in a bit more detail in subsequent sessions. So one of the first branches of the second part is going to be the masseteric artery, which I'm kind of drawing in where it's located right here. It's been cut here, and so it's really hard to understand what this artery branch is without a lot of the context, because you don't get the chance to see where it's really headed because the masseter muscle has been removed. We'll see a better view of this artery in a moment. But you can see the ascending posterior deep temporal artery here, which I'm drawing right there and putting a little arrow at. This artery also supplies a variable number of small pterygoid branches, which can supply portions of those pterygoid muscles of mastication. The anterior deep pterygoid artery is going to be a bit more anteriorly placed, as its name would suggest. That one's going to be the anterior temporalis. This will be the posterior temporalis, or temporal arteries. And you can really see them headed towards that temporalis muscle up here. They're going to head towards the deep part of the muscle, and that's where it's going to send the arterial supply. I wanted to show just one more view with the ramus completely intact in this particular image, but the masseter muscle has been reflected in this particular image. Temporalis muscle is still intact. You can really see its attachment to the coronoid process here. And you can also see the masseteric artery and the masseteric nerve right here as it's traveling over that mandibular notch to serve the masseter muscle, and it's going to go to the deep part of the muscle as most arteries and nerves do. So that's a really important anatomical relationship right there, how that masseteric neurovascular bundle will go over the mandibular notch. All right, so that is it for this video. As I mentioned at the beginning, we will focus on the maxillary artery and its branches in much greater detail in the infratemporal fossa session. Thank you for your time and attention.